by controlling the inductor, now this component showed that effect, that it is sensitive. It has that hill shape yield sensitivity histogram. So now we can do the same thing to this capacitor and control it, plus or minus 3% or 1%. So here I did controlling C-res 1, have increased my yield to 90%, 89%. So I got more yield because I used the yield sensitivity histogram and found out this. So now looking at the final results with controlling the inductor and the capacitor, notice that all the components now have flat yield relative to their tolerance. This is why I call this yield sensitivity histogram is like the X-ray machine. It finds in the circuit, in this oscillator, it pinpoints, it tells you the inductor or the capacitors are the problem in the design. It's like an X-ray machine. So what did we learn from this example? Yield sensitivity histogram helped us pinpoint the source of the yield problem in the design. And yield sensitivity histogram are generated using post-processing data of Monte Carlo yield analysis data. One thing I would like to mention before I move on in this presentation is we have added templates. They are now available and they are included in ADS 2008 update 2, and you can extract them from the data display. The templates are there and you can use them, and within a couple of minutes, within few minutes, you can use those templates in any design you have, and it will help you pinpoint which component is causing problems in your design for yield. So now let me show you a demo in ADS. And in this demo, I will use those templates that are already available for you in ADS. Okay, here's an example of a low noise amplifier, a KU band, 12 gigahertz low noise amplifier design. And by the way, this example is available in ADS 2008 update 2. You can go to the examples directory in the microwave circuits folder, and you can access this KU band LNA for DFM that has all the analysis, yield sensitivity histograms, design of experiments, sensitivity analysis. All the files are there, so you can educate yourself further by using this example. But this one, this circuit here, discusses the yield analysis. Like this resistor R1, I vary it plus or minus 5% uniform distribution. This capacitor, again, 5% uniform distribution. Even the dielectric constant, it's 12.9, and I vary it plus or minus 5%. The height of the substrate is 100 micron for mimic gallium arsenide, and I vary it plus or minus 3. So it's 97 to 103 in this example. So I put my variation, and when I have yield analysis here, done with the yield specs that I have. I'm running 1000 Monte Carlo trials. So when I run this simulation for this circuit, this is the output I get. And you can see from this plot, my yield for this LNA is 25%. I had 250 pass, 750 that failed, 25% yield. And these are my noise figure and gain and S22 return loss at the output results. So if I zoom on this, notice the fail region for the noise figure on the right side of this horizontal red line and the pass region on the left. And this is all the trials. And if I do this the same for the gain, this is the pass region, this is the fail region, and this is the gain distribution. Same thing with the S22, fail. Notice the S22, all of them are pass. I have good S22 below minus 15 dB is my spec, minus 15 dB. Okay, so So this is my yield analysis. And as I mentioned before, most designers perform Monte Carlo yield analysis in older designs. So once you perform this yield analysis and you have the data set that has all this Monte Carlo yield analysis is called on the top left corner, it's called BLNA yield. That's the name of the data set. It came from the circuit that I have simulated for yield. Okay, next I want to introduce you to that yield sensitivity histogram template that's available for you. And this is the template that shows on the top the total yield is equal to gain yield times noise figure yield times S22 yield. So now this template is giving us the overall yield for the three specs together. Okay, and notice in this template I am calling that data set BLNA yield, the same data set that I have simulated when I did the Monte Carlo yield. So this template will read in that data set to generate the information for us. Now on the right side here, I have an equation where you insert which component do you wanna look at. In this case, I have output matching network resistor R1. And notice what happened. R1 is shown here to be 20 ohms, and if it changes plus or minus 5%, so it's changing from 19 to 21, notice that when it goes to 21 ohms during the Monte Carlo yield analysis, the yield drops to zero. But if it goes to 19 ohms, the yield starts going up. What does this tell you? This is automatically telling me two things, that R1 wants to be a lower value. If you make it a lower value, you will increase your yield. The second thing is telling me not only that you can go to 19 ohm, let's say, but try to control it. Don't, like, instead of plus or minus 5%, maybe you can make it plus or minus 3% or 1%. And in Mimic, how do we do this? How do I make a resistor plus or minus 1% instead of 5%? It's very simple. Just in the layout, make it fat resistor. Instead of the width of the resistor 10 micron, make it 30 micron wide. And that would really improve the yield a lot. Because usually in the foundry process, the resistor tolerance is plus or minus half a micron. So half a micron from a 10 micron wide resistor is much more sensitive than half a micron from a 30 micron wide resistor. So this is the way you can control this resistor in the layout to reduce its sensitivity. Okay, now the next thing what I want to do is I can choose, instead of using output matching network resistor R1, let me choose output matching network capacitor C1. There is a capacitor in the output matching network. Now when I click C1 here, capacitor C1, notice automatically the data display or the template displays the yield sensitivity histogram relative to the capacitor C1. And what do we see here? That no matter what C1 does, its nominal value plus or minus 5%, the yield is flat. So it is not sensitive component. C1 is not a sensitive component. I don't have to worry about it. Keep it in the design. And so let's go to the input matching network, capacitor C1, different matching network. Now notice it's slightly different, but it's still showing that it is not very sensitive component. And if I go to input matching network R1, this is R1 in the input matching network. Again, it's not sensitive. So we can do this. You can do this for dielectric constant ER to see how my circuit is sensitive relative to dielectric constant. And you can see it is not. How about to the height of the substrate?